Hey, Tornado fans, we are back.
Back for the third period.
We got Matt and Aaron joining us, the locals. Just really enjoying this game, a whole lot of fun. NOCA, 2-0.
We enjoyed warming up too, it's a chilly one.
I bet, I stood out here and froze myself. And we're underway in the third period. Look. Hey, you got a little message from France from Monsieur Patrick Guibault.
Actually, from MSP. He's on his way through.
Oh, really?
Well, there's a chance for an open, but not on signs. 2-on-1 for the Chisago Lakes. Here's a shot. Oh, nice save.
Great centering pass by Chisago. Oh, great hockey, but they can't convert it. Parker comes up big with a save once again.
2-on-1, and they should have had a goal there. Chisago's going to have to do something here. They're not going to have a chance. No.
Still a whole lot of hockey to be played. 32 seconds into the first period. Jacob picks up the puck behind the net, sends it up to Nick. Puck rolled up the boards, managed to fool a Wildcat player. And Nick, skating into the corner, passes out front. Fred just not quite there. Jacob with the shot in. Seeing some nifty behind the back passes. Hunter's shot makes it all the way through.
That was a gift there at the end too, right on the Tornadoes.
Oh, that was. And then Austin with the attempt to put the second, the rebound away.
We're in science teachers here, but she doesn't want to talk to her.
Oh, well, you can hide here.
22's got to knock that guy down.
Little bumping and grinding, yeah.
I think he was a little outsized there, though.
Yeah. That was Ben on the face-off. Cole moving the puck out front. Sam over there in the far wing. Joe dumps it back in. Scoreboard read 2-1 for just a little bit, and they moved it back to 2-0. I think that might have been wishful thinking.
I think so. Maybe they counted that 2-on-1 before.
Yeah, what could have been, you know? Pass up to Cole.
37's gonna take him.
Cole gets bumped, comes out, Joe steps up, he launches one right at the goalie. Cole gets a face full of glove there. Goalie hangs on. Whole lot of chit-chat from the parents up in the stands. Part of the entertainment, just kind of. Yeah, we got the Finnish dad, eh? There, we got Fred's dad up. Oh, just past Matt's head. Big thumbs up. Fred out there on the ice just skirts the blue paint. And he gives chase as Chisago moves the puck out. Ryan tries to get rid of that one. Comes back, Ryan. Oh, just missed a handle on that puck. Parker covers up.
Smothered that one, that was probably a good move. The
yeah,
trailers didn't seem to be in place there. Well, you know, locally, tomorrow is the big celebration of the Lakes polka party.
Oh, fun.
At the Lindstrom City Hall.
You're gonna get out and polka for
admission's
that?
Admission's free and I'll have my dance shoes on.
Nice, oh, excellent. We should do a broadcast from there.
The hockey broadcast turned polka party.
Everybody polka. Holy cow. Jake gets his second of the contest. What did he?
A little too hot to handle it.
Yeah.
Blew it right by him.
Oh. As a goalie coach, I hate seeing those, but Yeah, it was a laser of a shot, just kind of snaked up the goalie's stick and into the net. Nobody was really expecting that one. Ananoka goes up
just
a nothing.
Threw it at the net, which is always a good move, and that one went in.
Yeah, sometimes that happens. You know, those go both ways. Parker actually got beat a few games ago on just a dump in just like that, but ugly little weird bounce, and goalies get beat sometimes.
That one did have some heat on it there.
Yeah. Yeah, it was partway between dump in and dump out, I guess, or shot.
Beauty!
Cool, getting matched stride by stride for stride by 97.
Pesky,
pesky number 97, of course. Austin dumping it into the Sagud zone. They little two-line pass, illegal when we were kids. Comes all the way out.
Yeah, that is another rule change, isn't it?
Yeah, that's
a dreaded two-line pass.
That's only a 30-year-old rule change, a two-line pass. Speeds the game up, I guess, if you can pass across two lines. Nick,
there's
pass. Yeah, Nick went down. He got bumped. Oh, Hunter took down number three. Little bit of tit for tat going on there, but it's I'm calling that small town reffing. Puck bounced off that back wall. It was a pretty heated shot from up here in the neutral zone.
23 might have got away with one there. That was a little bit from behind.
I think there's a few that would have gotten called in Anoka.
It's good that they're letting them play though. This is a good game.
Yeah. Well, really only one period aside, and that's unusual for this Anoka team. Although they've become a lot more disciplined later in the season. You know, we couldn't get a fair play point to save our lives earlier in the season, and now we're actually went eight straight, I think. Cole gets the puck, ducking and weaving through the middle into the slot area. He gets bumped off the puck. Joe with a shot, and Sam, great opportunity, just past the net. Into the corner. Sam finishes his check. Ben's out there. No, that was Cole, pardon me. Puck's all the way down.
Yeah, Chicago happy to get rid of that one. They were tired. They needed a change.
Oh, yeah. That's another difference in rules between here and the NHL.
You can dump it and make the change.
Exactly. Okay. Yeah. It was.
Well, that's what they looked like they were doing there.
All the way. Yep. Yep. Better to get a whistle with the puck at the far end of the ice than in the back of your own net. Wildcats attack. The back of the net. Kleiner giving chase. Jake gets that one. Ethan.
Oh! All alone in the slot, but he couldn't make it happen.
Tough one. That almost came up, and it was a great opportunity for the Wildcats. Check getting finished on Ethan. Ethan exchanging pleasantries with number four, Jake. Couple of bumps there too. Number 86, great player, gets by Ryan, but Kleiner stops him. Pucks up to Ethan, but he can't quite hold on to that one. 13, skates through his own zone.
He gets the Jets, but he just couldn't get around that corner.
Yeah, it was kind of tough getting by Jake.
Yeah, there's a lot of real estate to cover there.
Yeah, Jake rubbed him out, but he did have that head of steam. A couple of guys on our team that are good at that. Jake, the defenseman with the slightly redder helmet. That's offsides. Not a whole lot of offsides calls either.
No.
Yeah, Jacob. Jacob right down here, he'll get a head of steam and he'll plow through everybody and done some great things, couple of goals that way. He tries to clear that one. Austin dumps it up. Chisago dumping it back in the zone. Nick. Going along the boards. Moves that one out. Jacob bumps his man. Hunter passes across to Nick. Oh, yeah. Nick beats one man. 97 puts a body on him, takes him out of the play. No, number 97, good job to come out of nowhere and kind of thwart things. Cole, couple of nice moves, steps back over the line, and poor Sam had to hustle to get back onside. Sam lines his guy up, doesn't finish the check. Freddie gets a bump. Ben in the corner, takes a look. Didn't have a D open to pass to, but then Wildcats come up with a puck. 7:49 left in the third period, 3-0 Naroka. Jacob dumps for, oh, they got away with an offside there. Ben was in the air, I think, so they gave it to him. And we got a penalty coming up here?
I'm not sure. I thought it was offsides.
Yeah, just an offsides.
He's pointing all the way down. I'm not sure why.
It's another obscure rule I don't know about.
Yeah, I missed that.
It's like
that.
A simple offsides.
Have to check that one in the replay.
Is it aggravated offsides or something?
Yeah. Yeah, intentional offsides, you'll see him bring it back, but very rarely all the way back down like that. Cole beats his man. Centering pass by attempt by Ethan gets picked up by the Wildcats. Joe rubs his man out. Puck behind the net.
Erin's getting a little frustrated. She's not used to seeing non-pros.
Kind of spoiled. Well, these guys are pretty darn good, but they're not NHL material just yet. Working on it.
28 was looking for the hat either.
Oh, yeah. Hey, I got my hat at the ready.
I might have to keep this one.
Did I tell you what happened? That laser of a shot by Josh. Yeah, this one, I think Patrick Hockey, there's another shameless plug, might give me a replacement. Yeah. Although my head's going to get pretty cold if I throw
cold,
it on.
It's cold to walk home tonight without it.
Yeah.
86 has got the wheels, but there's nobody there to help him.
Yeah. It's,
1-on-4.
Wildcats were getting the change, much needed change. Jake trying to push his way through. You could tell he was ready for a change too. Nick giving chase. Number 13 uses his head of steam.
For Chisago. Oh, but they couldn't get it at the net.
Oh, pretty frustrating for those guys. Joe gets away with one there as he upends guy out. Number 41 gets a little bit of revenge there. And
nice
Kleiner skating
over
for the
here
corner.
By four.
Well, you see our guys are, their heads are on a swivel because they know they're going to get schmucked when they chase the puck into the corner there. So they're looking over their shoulders to see where the check's coming from. Anoka dumps in there. They get the change. 5:20 remaining. Oh, Ryan stands his guy up. Ref goes down now, too. He's got bare hands, and he's keeping those off the ice. Cole with the shot. That one gets blocked. Puck comes way all the way out, and Parker covers up. Decides to do that rather than playing it.
Patrick said it was 65. He doesn't know what I'm talking about with the cold weather.
Oh. 65 in Phoenix. Yeah, that's cold.
Yeah.
So he's just on his way through. He's not stopping in Minneapolis.
That's what he's saying.
A big bienvenue à Minnesota for Monsieur Guibault. just stopping through at the moment in MSP Airport on his way back to, is he going home to Toulouse?
Yeah, I think he's on his way back home.
I missed him the last couple of visits. So.
Well, he hasn't been by.
Jacob clears his own. Good thing he did, because only Hunter's back, and Jacob with the head of steam, he gets a puck stripped away from him, but he still got it. Gets schmucked behind the Wildcats net. Jacob jumped back to point to cover for him. Jake gets a shot, and the Wildcats goalie pounces on that one. 4:23 remaining in the third period. Time's dwindling. See if the Wildcats can get a goal to at least salvage a little bit of pride. Spoil things for Anoka, but... And they're on the attack. Hunter, nice defensive play. Ben grabs the puck behind the net. A little bit of a check finish by Cole. Puck into the neutral zone. Cole's getting a lot of ice tonight. Not sure what the call was there. Offsides. Might have been a high stick there. Puck came all the way around until the ref whistled it, but must have been a high stick that we didn't see. Ben gives to Sam. Sam with the opportunity. No mistake. Puts it top shelf.
That was a laser right to the top corner.
Yeah, Sam's got a pretty wicked shot. He's scored some pretty goals out there.
The goalie touched it. That thing was going in all the way. No.
Ben got the apple on that one. Made the play, beautiful pass. Sam had a whole lot of open ice in front of him. Walks in, puts her home.
Now you put 28 out there and get him to Hattie.
They got this one in control.
Yep. Yeah, despite Wildcats putting up a heck of a struggle. Funny bounce off the boards there. No, the Cats have put up a pretty good game. So they're... What did I say? They were 6th or 7th in the district.
Well,
in Olka.
It was really close.
Yeah, they're not one of the teams that's... they're below 500. Joe shot into traffic. That doesn't make it through to the net. Hey, we're going to get a selfie here for Patrick.
Well, we should. He's certainly one
of them. Oh, you know, nice picture there.
Let's see if I can figure this. I got a new phone here.
All right,
Aaron,
selfie time. Selfie time. One with Aaron.
Yep. I'll push it.
I got it.
Got him. Good job.
All right, and a fine selfie taken.
Yeah. I don't take a lot of selfies, except we're in the wrong spot.
Oh, we should be pointed.
No, it's just reverse.
Oh, okay. Oh yeah, that's a problem with selfies.
Yeah.
Well, as long as the hat trick hockey logo is...
Oh, was it? We better make sure.
Anoka tagging up on the offside. That goes all the way back. That's going to be icing.
I didn't?
No, you're so mean.
I think you still got to send it.
No, I didn't. Shoot.
4-0. After that goal by Sam, Jake's got a pair.
These things are expensive, sending them internationally.
Oh yeah. That's why I get my employer to pay for my cell phone.
I think it's 25 cents a click.
Oh boy.
What?
Did you take a picture?
No, if I send it to somebody in France, you know he's here.
You should get him to use WhatsApp. And then you're just using data.
Right. Well, I used to have text free or something like that, but it got inconvenient.
Oh, yeah. Ryan gets the puck out of the zone. Ethan tied up.
2 minutes to go here. I'm waiting for Chisago to pull the goalie.
Yeah, it's just about goalie pulling time. Big pass goes off.
He's going to have to wipe that black mark off his
visor,
there.
Yeah. The only player out there with the plastic visor. Jake finishing a check. Number four is going to feel that
one. It says Maiden Czechoslovakia right on his visor.
I've used that line before. And now, Tornado fans, you know where I got that line. I love that one. I used that with...
It doesn't say that anymore, though, right? They say, like, Slovakia or something.
Slovakia or the Czech Republic. Right. I once had three pucks. One said Czech Republic, one said Slovakia, and the other said Czechoslovakia. It was an older puck out of my puck bag. I don't know where the three of them went.
Awesome.
Probably into a snowbank somewhere. Yeah, I actually used that line with... Ron Shero was on the broadcast a couple of weeks ago, and so we had a good laugh over that one.
Ooh.
Sam Ooh. Grabs that puck.
Who wants to know if that's green next time?
Oh, Ben with the opportunity. He gets a chance at a second goal. That one... goalie got a piece of that one, just enough. Pucks back to Jacob. Jacob lines it in. Hunter stops that one cold with his face. And 97 with the opportunity, but Sammy got a piece of that one, dumps it out. 22 seconds left, time's dwindling. Wildcats decided not to pull a goalie. Jacob behind the back pass. Oh, Chisago's putting something together. And Ben had gotten that one. There goes Sam. He's got 3 seconds to do something. He gets creamed just as the buzzer goes off. And the game will end 4-0 Anoka. Parker getting the shutout. And he did a pretty good job earning that one. Anoka goes to 11-2-2 on the season. That'll put him pretty close to first place in the district. Players
nice
chatting
for
a little
the
bit.
Tornadoes. They had this one in hand from the get-go.
It was not a cakewalk by any stretch of the imagination. They earned it.
Well, the ice seemed to be tilted mostly their way. Shots were 22-18. I don't think they were that close. I think that was some hometown shot counting there.
Well, it's tough to count shots when you're sitting in the box. Yeah. When you're running the scorebook, you got half a dozen different jobs. And so, gotta thank our volunteers for helping out with the game officiating. So, hey, thank you very much. It was just a gas having you along in the broadcast, you and Erin.
Fun night, fun evening. Erin, she wants to play next year. She's ready.
Really? That's awesome.
We're going to lace them up, aren't we?
Hey, can always use more players out there on the ice. Yeah, so.
Shoots left, right? Shoots left.
Heck of a skater, too, I hear.
Yep. She likes to lace them up and go skate out on the lake.
Yeah, a whole lot of beautiful lakes up in this part of the state.
When her friends come over, we put the skates on, right?
Nice.
Did you see her hat? She's got a nice wild hat.
Oh, wow. Yeah, that's a pretty fancy one. Yeah, my kid's got one pretty similar to that. So pretty cool duds.
I've got a fun story behind this hat.
Oh, yeah?
Years ago, I used to fish in bass tournaments. And the Minnesota Wild had a 10,000 ranks charity event. And they asked me if I would fish in it. And I had then one of the owners of the team in my boat. We had a really good time.
Oh, wow.
And then during that event, I got to meet my childhood idol, Neil Broughton.
Nice.
When you're a kid and you're watching the 1980 Olympic team, and prior to that, the Gophers, and prior to that, the high school hockey tournament.
Uh-huh.
Neil Broughton was your idol. He was mine anyways.
That's so pretty cool.
That was real fun. Neil Broughton bought me a beer.
No. Wow. Pretty cool story. Love that. Well, hey, we're going to wrap things up and go in and get warm. I should probably go talk to my goalie for a little bit.
I think it's time to warm up.
Big shout out. So, hey, thank you guys for joining the broadcast.
Say goodbye, Aaron.
Bye-bye, Aaron. Yeah, thanks for joining us. We'll see you next time. I'm not sure a future game. I'm not going to be able to make the one in St. Cloud on Sunday morning, or the may make it to the one in Cambridge, but we'll see. So thanks for joining us. We'll see you next time right here on Tornado TV.
Bye now.
Bye now.